Morning, nigga.
It's worth mentioning that Uncle Ruckus is running for mayor. Why? A couple of years ago,
a new face in the Republican campaign race from seemingly out of nowhere, a Mr. Uncle Ruckus.
Financed by billionaire banking tycoons and Mr. Burns knockoff, Ed Wunsler, and his economy-crushing son, Eddie Jr.
This Mr. Ruckus is not, I repeat, not an African-American, but rather a Caucasian man suffering from a rare skin condition called revitiligo.
It's the opposite of what Michael Jackson got. Lucky bastard.
Liberals are, of course, ridiculing this man's disease, which I can assure you is completely real, unlike rape.
Yes, that's right. Uncle Ruckus ran for president and basically almost won. His standout moment was during the first Republican primary debate.
Uncle Ruckus, give us your strongest critique of President Obama. 1 minute.
I don't need a minute. He's a black sumbitch from the sweaty jungles of Kenya. I yield the rest of my time.
He's got my vote.
And may we one day get to a world where no porcelain goddess feels the need to pump up her beautiful ironing board flat ass to airbag-sized proportions just to attract some five-time baby daddy, bad free-throwing nigga athlete. Amen.
Hey, whoa, Ruckus, what the hell are you doing here? This is a serious matter.
Oh, I know it's serious. Word round the street is that you live in a serious nigga dream. Oh, you got your own personal ATM in the form of a rich white girl. Oh, and she ain't just any kind of white. She Armenian from the home of the glorious Caucasus Mountains. Get it? Caucasus. Caucasian. We see what you're doing.
Oh, Ruckus, what's wrong with a young woman spending on an old man? Reverse happen all the time.
Oh, it just ain't natural, Robert. It ain't natural. Men are supposed to be the strong heads of household. White women's job is to make sandwiches and look pretty. Now, once ladies start controlling the push strings, things get crazy. They just let themselves go. Hell, we got a career woman right now down in 232. Bitch lost her cell phone and her own body fat.
You fat motherfucker, I'm tired of your shit!
Once national news, now public access, Ruckus continues his service to the American people.
You see, fellow white Americans, this is why I am running for mayor. Now, being black is bad. Ain't no question about that. And being poor is bad. But this nigga has the nerve to be both. Pay your bill, deadbeat nigga.
Ruckus, I don't have time for this. What are you doing here?
Question is, Robert, what are you doing here? Here in the white man's house that you cannot afford. Oh, what? What? You thought you could pay your mortgage with food stamps, nigga?
Woodcrest Tea Party Chairman Uncle Ruckus staged a small protest at the venue today.
Who keeps giving these high yellow felons record contracts? Oh, it's just a record, you say? Well, white folks, you won't be saying that when the nigger that sings on that record comes to town and impregnates all the white women of child-rearing age. And that is exactly what he plans to do. Just think of all the government money and food stamps that them little mixed-race quadroon nigger children will be consuming. And they consume a whole lot more than regular children because they eating for two races.
Look, you fat one-eyed bastard, I don't need this today.
This is the thanks I get. I was on my way to tape Jimmy Kimmel, and I thought I would stop by and see how y'all niggas was doing. Hey, how'd that black president thing work out for you?
Ruckus, enough! How do you know about my house payments anyway? You come by to rub it in?
No, sir, I did not. I came by to tell you I quit. Now that I'm an official Woodcrest mayoral candidate, I will no longer work for y'all niggas. Mexicans or swarthy Persians.
Fact, beat it!
Get off me, Robert! Get your nigga hands off me! Oh, what a surprise! The nigga is resorting to violence. Oh, I knew it! I knew it! Citizen's arrest! I'm making a citizen's arrest! All right, get moving, get moving. Avert your eyes, avert your eyes. Just a nigga going to jail, nothing to see now.
Oh, come on. I thought you gave up work to run for mayor.
I didn't give up work. I gave up working for niggas and other colors like Mexicans and sand people. Now you better grab some suds and start waxing hoods. Wax on, wax off, nigga.
Uncle Ruckus is back on the scene, ruffling small town feathers with bold ideas.
Barack Hussein Obama thinks black people made this country great. Now, wait a minute. He almost right. The white half of him right. Because the white businessman, that white entrepreneur who had the sense to look at a big black African Negro man, put that nigga in chains, drag his black ass all the way over here to America to do some productive work. Now that's what's made America great. Thank you, friends. Thank you. That, my friends, is how come we are losing to the Chinese. Because the China man uses slave labor and we don't. Apple computers don't need to be using no Chinese slave labor. They should be using good, old-fashioned, blacky, American slave labor. Oh, look at that. Feel that, nigga. Feel that. That feeling is called work. That's what white folks been doing their whole lives.
Shut up, Ruckus. When do I get paid?
I don't know, nigga. You fired.
Fired? Why?
It wasn't me. The car wash brass is cutting back hours. Tough luck, nigga. We'll call you when we need you. Sorry, I only hire Mexicans, too. It's that damn Obama's fault. That's why you can't get a job.
Oh, Ruckus, you think everything is Obama's fault?
That's because it is. He got elected and made good white folks feel self-conscious about hiring niggas. See, a shoeshine boy is somebody you should feel comfortable talking to about anything. About your mistress. About how you hate fuck your wife. Somebody you should feel comfortable calling a nigga, because nowadays, you just can't get them friendly greetings out at work. You don't want to look up one day and see that shoeshine ball on your TV talking about Mahuma-Hama-Jama-Jama-Gina-Jaws and clean energy. That just complicates the relationship.
But I'm not running for president.
Oh, that is true. But you know who's really never going to be the president? A wetback illegal. You can go home after kicking his prayer candle dipped in tapatio smelling ass and feel comfortable. You will never see his illegal ass in the Roosevelt room.
So what should I do?
Nothing. You ain't got no chance. As much as them Negroes con queso annoy me, they have one hell of a work ethic. Hell, to get more work done, they even import little mini versions of themselves. Guatemalans, I think they call them. Look at this. Oh, how the high yellow shall be last. And the last shall be high yellow.
Leave me alone, Ruckus. I'm working as fast as I can.
Oh, yeah, nigga. Oh, this ain't nothing like the movie Car Wash, is it, nigga? Oh, no. Ain't no singing. No dancing. No Richard Pryor. Nothing. Oh, by the way, that lazy Mexican sumbitch Chico canceled. And I need you to stay till closing time.
But I had plans tonight.
Plans? Plans? Ain't no nigga make no plans. Niggas just react to outside stimuli. Now, I got some plan, too. I plan to keep your black ass here.
Some bitch!
Isn't there anyone who can help this man?
Yes, sir, Mr. Kindly Billionaire White Man. Uncle Ruckus can help you with that broke nigga.
Slavery?
Yeah, you could be in Africa right now. They got some shit down there that makes you bleed all over the place.
It makes you bleed to death.
Yeah, you sweat blood. Y'all in America, we ain't gotta worry about none of that shit, right?
Uncle Ruckus ain't got no dog in this fight. I hate niggas and I hate faggots. And I especially hate when they both combine together, like that damn RuPaul. Two things I hate in one. Oh, seriously, the only kind of white man I can't respect is a gay white man. Them and the average white band, because they make nigga music.
I have the right to discriminate. Heterosexual couples only.
This is a proud day. The day we bring slavery back to America. Finally, worthless niggas like these now have real value to this country. Thanks to the brilliance and generosity of the white man and his well-run financial institution.
I want my reparations now!
Ah!
nigger. You're supposed to be at the car wash. I'm docking you a 4-day pay.
It's not fair! I can't take it! Those motherfuckers! They took everything! They can't get away with it! They can't! They can't get away with it! Huey, I don't care what you say. I'm gonna eat my pizza and watch my basketball wives and scratch.
Hello, Robert. A nice white delivery man gave me a pizza for $1.
Now, let's see how many slices. 1, 2. Wait a minute, I'm gonna say it in Spanish. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Probably got scared once he learned niggas live around here and didn't want to die senselessly.
What do you want, Ruckus? Nobody got time for your foolishness.
Mr. Wansler II sent me over here. Said he wants to see you in his office immediately.
What's Eddie want with us now?
Bro, I'm about to really have to beat this nigga ass, bro. Man, get that fool, man.
Oh, there you niggas go with that. Oh, what he want now? What he want now? Lucky the white man wants to talk to you broke niggas at all. White man brings you nothing but opportunity. You should want to talk to him 24 hours a day.
Well, you can go tell Junior if he wants to talk to us, he can bring his ass over here just like you did.
Well, ain't that the pot calling the nigga black? I guess you forgot Mr. Wansler owns your asses, which is akin to owning the air in a balloon. Cause you niggas ain't worth shit.
What you mean to say is all the niggas you fuck with ain't shit. You need to figure out what it is about your pussy that keep attracting ain't shit niggas.
I ain't going nowhere.
Well, Robert, as much as it pains me to do this.
Now, where was I?
Now, the writers were unaware at that point that they were heading towards serious danger. Birmingham was the most racist city in the whole country, run by a maniac named Bull Connor.
I hate niggers! I hate them! I hate them!
And right next to Bull Connor, helping him organize this violence against the writers, was an equally despicable man.
The day my hero, Bull Connor, called and asked for my help dealing with them freedom-riding niggers, was the happiest day of my life.
Wait, you mean Ruckus was at the Birmingham station? All this time I didn't know that. That black son bitch, boy, I'm gonna have to kick his ass when I see him.
Robert Freeman was there? Well, ain't that something? Small world.
Damn it, my lady is not dying until we've had a real benefits talk up in here.
Oh, did I hear a nigga raising his voice in the ICU? Okay, nigga, that's it. Your government benefits have expired. Come with me.
If you don't get your damn hands off of me.
Oh, sure. It starts with buses. But next, they will want to integrate schools and restaurants. And before you know it, some nigga will want to integrate the sweet pink nether regions of your white wife, or your white daughter, or your dear sweet white grandmother. Do any of y'all know what a BBC is?
No!
You don't want to know. It does much damage. You have 15 minutes, 900 seconds to do whatever your heart desires to these shiftless black bastards before the law shows up. So I am begging you, white men, do not hold back on these niggas. Let the full strength of your Caucasianism rain down upon them. Believe me, they can't do much, but a nigga can take an ass whooping. I promise.
What kind of job wears suits on the night shift?
Less important job. Valet and pimps.
Which one are you?
Hush, don't worry about what I am. Know what you should be worrying about? Behaving for the babysitter.
Hello, little niggas. Well, go on. Get out there and sell that shriveled up monkey dick. See you in the morning, ho man.
Huh?
Ruckus, I'm not a whore man. I'm an escort.
Escort? Ha! Let me break down escort for you. Webster Dictionary will tell you an escort is a smart, pretty white woman who, temporarily down on her luck, uses the powers of her gold-plated vagina to care for her adorable kids. You, my nigga, is a hoe.
Granddad, that's your job?
Yeah, but I didn't swallow dick for tips, you dirty skank.
Yes, you did, you lonely, miserable bitch.
You got that right, Tom. God bless America. Welcome to Freedom Land, you lazy bastards. This here is your orientation.
Ruckus, are you trying to tell us that we're supposed to act like slaves and be cool with it? Really?
That is correct. Here you will learn to look down when a rich white man is coming. Buck dance if you hear anything resembling a tune. And denounce any feelings that resemble self-esteem and or self-worth.
Not on your life, Ruckus.
Yeah, we ain't going for this shit. First rich white man I see, I'm telling him to suck. I ain't seeing shit. You can call me Toby, Obama, Cleveland.
That's right, nigga. That is right. Now, there will be a short boot camp to make sure you niggas are limber and don't have a massive heart attack, which will make our rich patients feel bad for not voting for universal health care.
Dear niggas, I hope this note finds you well. In the interest of you taking your agitating black asses back to where you came from, a bomb has been placed on this bus. That bomb will detonate if the bus exceeds 15 miles an hour.
Oh, that's right. It was like the opposite of that cinematic classic, Speed, starring the great Keanu Reeves and that American sweetheart, Sandra Bullock.
If you stop the bus, the bomb will not explode. If anyone leaves the bus, the bomb will not explode.
And if you turn that bus around and leave decent white folks alone, then the bomb will not explode. Huh. If you ask me, I think that was perfectly reasonable.
What the?
Want me to make you a plate?
Wait, how the hell did you get into my house?
Well, our first date went so well, I upgraded to the if I catch you looking at another bitch, I'll kill you package. The one that comes with a house key?
Stalker.
Oh, don't look at me. I thought that nappy-headed woman was a bear. I kept trying to lock the door.
She's one of my clients.
Look at you, bringing work home. Mm-hmm. Very unniggardly of you, Robert.
Shut up, Ruckus. We gotta get her out.
Oh, that is a powerful request. Them big thigh blackens just like bedbugs. Once they in, you got to damn near burn your whole house down to get them out. Okay, I do have one solution, even more powerful than pouring water on they hair. Give me some time.
3 hours later.
Oh, the freak Nick Sakis has come to town in Robert Freeman's living room.
Girls, that's Ruckus. He is crazy.
But if he's Robert's friend, then he's my friend, too.
Mm. Oh, there's my African prince!
That's right. I didn't forget your request. The most powerful black bitch be gone ever. A beautiful white woman.
No! Make her leave!
That ain't possible. White women are loyal. For real. Try to kick her. She'll just love you more.
But I'll tell you one thing, I'm gonna make sure they understand you will not perpetuate the snow bunny crisis.
I don't see what the big deal is.
The big deal? The big deal is that women would pay to fuck you. Nigga, you know you would fuck anything for free.
That dick slid right in them sweet walls.
You tell them I want them lying in the streets, the rooftops, everywhere you can get them. These niggas will not cross the state line. Ruckus?
Brave white man of law enforcement, you are the last line of defense for the white man's entire glorious way of life. If that bus crosses this line, it sets off a series of irreversible changes. First, there will be integrated diners and bathrooms and then schools. There will be nigger quarterbacks, niggers winning Academy Awards, niggers playing doctors on television, and eventually, even the White House won't be white. White men! You must stop this bus!
Good. Now scram before someone shoots your black ass by mistake.
Oh, yes, sir, Mr. Bull, sir.
Hey, rich, mostly white chillin'. Make some noise if your nanny speaks Spanish! Oh, I can't hear you! I hope everybody enjoyed the Welfare Queen for a Day exhibit. And we got real meth and crack-addicted kids at the gift shop. Use them as your servants. We don't give a fuck. See the concierge on your way out.
Huh?
Where you niggas think y'all going?
We're going home, Ruckus. The park is closed.
Oh? You niggas don't get it, do you? This is your home. Oh, no, seriously. You niggas live here now.
What's next, Siri?
You have a checkers game with Uncle Ruckus in the park in 15 minutes.
I almost forgot.
What? 8 games in a row? Nigga, you must be cheating. God damn it. Oh,
what, nigga? Or you think you somebody just cause you got the white man telephone? Well, whoop-de-doo for a nigga like you. The white man is so brilliant, he can make a sophisticated piece of technology so easy to use, even a bald-headed nigga like you can do it. You ain't nothing but a monkey with a fancy telephone. Matter of fact, you've been looking an awful lot at that thing. Let me see it. Ha! Culture, nigga.
Dorothy Dandridge. Robert, if you're gonna Photoshop, at least make it a white woman.
Ruckus, you must be out of your damn mind. Yeah!
Boy. The sound of that whip so well sweet. It's like Jesus gently snapping his fingers. Now, Robert and Tom, you have good white man names, so we will leave your names be. But you two little niggas, oh, you have aggressive names, and as such, they will be changed. Huey, you are now Nigger One, or One for short. Riley, your name is Nigger Two, or Two for short. Two! Took that bell of hay to my horse, who I've affectionately named Nigger. Even though he is white, he has wide nostrils.
My name's not Platt. My name...
Your name is Platt.
Oh, Nigger gonna die today.
This is inhumane!
Who the hell said that Niggers was human in the first place? One, get Nigger some carrots. Uh-oh. One, is you defying me, boy?
I mean, niggas get beat up all the time, but people really get off seeing you get your ass beat.
Robert Freeman, you the only person I know can get his ass whooped by a nigger he already killed a dozen times before. I mean, by nature, niggers lose. They losers. They natural bone losers. But you like some kind of heptathlete losing.
Not now, Ruckus. Not now.
Well, I'd actually lower my voice, seeing as how you just got your ass whooped. Completely embarrassing. Oh, I can't see how a man could achieve a quality erection after getting beaten that bad. Yes. Welcome home, nigger.
Ruckus, this is insane. You can't keep us here.
Well, it looks to me like I can do whatever I want to, slave. Oh, slave. That tastes good in my mouth. What a joyous feeling it is just to say that word. It's like saying love. Reaganomics.
People don't actually live here, do they?
People, no. Once little slaves, yes. Oh, it's not as bad as, say, them slave castles in Senegal. This is more like an NFL training camp. See them slaves over there? Oh, look at their forearms and legs just getting strong. Yes, this is good for the body and the soul.
How can that be good?
Well, that cotton is organic. This is a good day for me, because I love it. Nothing makes me happier than to see the coons and the benders tear each other down. But one thing Uncle Ruckus will not tolerate, and you may write this down, is disrespect to the mentally afflicted. And sometimes, with niggas, it can be difficult to spot mental disabilities. Because let's face it, suffering from brain damage is something niggas do very well. That's why all the best mentally challenged men have always been black. Michael Clark Duncan in Green Mile, Cuba Gooding Jr. in Radio, and that big black nigga from The Blind Side. Sandra Bullock was good in that movie, don't get me wrong. But that big dumb football nigga, oh, he was a natural.
I won't be free until we're all free.
Tom, Sarah bought your freedom. You can go.
Well, guys, it's been real.
Ruckus, you've done some stupid shit, but come on! This is insane. We are friends.
Friends? Ain't no friends when it comes to slavery, real or make-believe. Now, since I was cursed with revitiligo and bone in the 20th century, I never got my chance to experience the beauty and magical nature known as slavery. Finally, I get my chance to show Master I'm not like them field niggas. I got his back. Oh, and don't get no crazy ideas about writing letters to Abraham Lincoln looking for help. Any slave I kept reading or writing will be shot immediately. Good night. No, I'm serious. I will shoot you. Pray to your new true God, White Jesus. That'll make it all better. Okay, sleep tight.
Damn.
Okay, 40 acres and a mule. Come on now, 40 acres. That's a lot of land.
You and I both know we'll never see it.
Mr. Wansler, sir, now I know you simply wanted me to bring him here to this meeting, but just whistle, and I will be on him like white on rice.
Not for long.
Stop being all freedom fighter, and I'll give your grandfather a nice cushy job. You know, one where he has no real power, but your people are happy because he has a nice office and gets CNN soundbites.
I'm gonna have to pass.
What good is it for a man to gain the whole world, yet lose his soul?
Ruckus!
How dare you go darker than Mr. Wansler's thoughts with your nigger logic! Did you want the door open?
Oh, my bad, Mr. Goldcard. Excuse me, sir. Thank you for helping out a post-street nigga like me, sir. You can go now, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Nigga, who you think I am, nigga?
This is
gorgeous. Step right up. Step right up and take your chance to break the angry nigga that cannot be broken. Okay, okay, slow it down. Slow it down. There'll be enough for everybody. This nigga ain't giving in. So it's another step up the humiliation ladder. Tar and feather it.
Hold it. I got a better idea. Let me have it. The folks here want historical accuracy. I'm gonna give it to them.
Oh, that is good. Cut off that slave's foot and he ain't going nowhere. Mr. Wansler, you is pure genius. Oh, the master loves tap dancing. He says the tippity-tap of nigger feet is so meditative.
Ruckus?
From now on, my name is not Ruckus. It is false! No!
I hate to break my amusement park character, but there are documents called the Constitution and the Emancipation Proclamation, and they specifically forbid keeping us here against our will.
Yeah, you may have a point there, Tom. I could let you go. Or... Mr. Wansler, this is worse than the Planet of the Apes.
Get me out of here, Ruckus.
Watch your step, Mr. Wansler. Watch your step. There you go. There you go. Gentle. Baby. Don't you remember when he signed his freedom away to Mr. Eddie? Shoot, you niggas should be grateful you're not working at Sub-Saharan Food Bank land. Honored guests, and you niggas as well. We are gathered here today to witness an unprecedented union between Robert Freeman and the niggas' telephone. Now, when Robert Face called me to perform this ceremony, I was conflicted. I was messed up inside and out. Sure, sure. Robert, high yellow as he is still a nigger down to the bone. And while Siri here is not an actual Caucasian woman, she does have the intellect and silky smooth voice of a Caucasian woman. However, I had to take into consideration that Siri does not have an actual Caucasian woman's vaginal region for Robert the Negro to penetrate over and over and over again and again with his twisted Negro penis. Also, we of the Tea Party are strict believers in personal freedom, as long as that personal freedom does not involve man-on-man faggotry or smoking of reefer. Therefore, I decided it was okay to do this favor for my poor, lonely, deranged, former employer.
Okay, that's enough. Get on with it.
Okay, fine, nigga, fine. I gotta take my time. Now, if anybody out there has any reason that this nigga should not marry his telephone, which should be everybody, speak now or forever hold our peace.
I object.
What?
I'm in love with him.
Nigga, you know you would fuck anything for free. Boy, you niggas just don't know a good thing when you see it. Him, Mr. Wansler, out of the goodness of his heart, was gonna give you free housing, food, a job, everything a nigga could want. Tell me, you ungrateful bastards, what could ever be greater than Freedom Land?
Freedom.
Check. Yeah. Yeah. You're all the reason why I do this. My mom asked me what's the reason I'm so influenced. And I can only tell her that things will only get better. To get to another level, I gotta follow this music. Sometimes it's led me down the dark and lonely road. And where that road would end, I tell you, heaven only knows. But my pursuit of happiness depends on upper management. The whole weight of the world, I guess, is my burden to carry it.